Endeavour from My Hero Academia certainly gets a lot of negativity for the fanbase, and it is well deserved. However, today I want to explore if Endeavour can become a redeemable character. Hi guys, welcome to the Fangirl. I'm your hostess McGann, and I have recently been just a little bit obsessed with MHA, which you can tell by me bringing back my flame hair. And I did that just for this video. Really, I had avoided this show for years because anytime I saw a clip, it looked really weird and activated my bonitis senses. But then my daughter got hooked on it, she wheedled me into watching it, and now sweet little baby Aerie is my soul. But I also find myself arguing nonstop with my daughter because I really like Endeavour. I initially wanted to hate him, I'm sure like everybody else, but he's slowly been winning me over. Am I the only one? I mean, that season 4 finale was an incredible display of the kind of hero that Endeavour could be. But let's cover everything we know so far about Japan's new number one superhero. Okay, let's just start out by not sugarcoating anything. Endeavour, whose normie name is Enji Todoroki, is brass, he's rude, he has a very hostile nature about him that's not very heroic at all, and he's a flippin' wife beater! He also supposedly purchased his wife Rei because of her ice-related quirk, because Endeavour is a tad bit of a narcissist whose main goal in life is to provide the seed to the world's perfect superhero. Rei, however, is noted to have a weaker constitution, and she never fully mastered her powers, which, as you might imagine, left her susceptible to abuse when she tried to stand up to her bully of a husband. Endeavour really seemed to be torturing his wife by treating their children like little soldiers and then tossing them to the side if they didn't perform as desired. And when one of their kids finally did have the potential to perform, like Shoto did, Endeavour's training of that child ended up being so rough and severe that Rei had a mental breakdown. She was being abused, it was hurting her double to watch her son suffer, and one day she just snapped and burnt the kid's face, leaving him with a permanent scar. And all things considered, that's likely why Shoto is so quick with his reflexes now. Because when he was little, he trusted his mother, and so he hesitated to react when he sensed danger, and then his face got burned. And in case anybody is watching this who doesn't know any different, that is not okay, that is not normal. Now, this is where things head over into a weird area, because due to the scarring, Endeavour commits his wife to a mental institution. And I mean, I can't really blame him. Yeah, Endeavour was horrible to Rei, but you can't exactly leave your children with someone who might maim or kill them as soon as you're not looking. And it is curious that Endeavour never seems to have divorced his wife, and he keeps trying to visit her in the institution. And even though the doctors won't let the two meet face to face, Enji is still regularly leaving his wife flowers, which suggests he does love her and he does feel some sort of romantic or guilty feelings about her. And that makes me wonder, how much do we not know? And in that unknown area, is there room for Endeavour to become a redeemable character? Peeking just a little bit into the manga, Rei and Enji have a total of 4 children. This hasn't been covered in the anime yet, unless I just missed it somehow, but Enji and Rei's oldest son, Toya, had a significant fire quirk that was actually stronger than his father's. However, Toya was never quite strong enough to master his powers, which Endeavour blamed on Rei's weak constitution, and that failure to pass muster prompted Endeavour to ignore Toya for not being good enough. I feel like I say Toya differently every single time, but you guys know who I mean, right? Then at some point after Rei gets locked away, Toya dies in an accident that has a bunch of sketchy, unclear details. The death of her son made Rei get mentally worse, and even Endeavour is shown to grieve and prove that he does have a heart for his children, even though it doesn't come up to the surface much. And if we focus on the Endeavour that we get to see before season 4, there are a few different things that we can surmise from his personality. As Endeavour was the number 2 rated hero in Japan, right behind All Might, obviously Endeavour is a very skilled, powerful individual. He's worked hard for his entire life to climb the hero ladder, and he's stuck at the number 2 spot, which Endeavour surely sees as being the first loser. But why? Well, what I've come to realize through experience is that people who walk a big walk and talk a big talk tend to have a severe inferiority complex. And with the way that Endeavour fixates on being the number two hero, unable to surpass All Might, that shows us that the inferiority issue is a major defining piece of Enji's psyche. Then, as we know, every quirk has its drawbacks, and Endeavour himself can only expel so much heat before it takes a toll on him. So, how do you counter that? Well, he can't. There is nothing that Enji can do to fix that problem. However, if Enji were to choose a mate wisely, he could combine his quirk with someone else's quirk and potentially engineer an unstoppable hero. Enter Rei and her ice quirk. And I do want to be clear that the issue of Rei and Enji's marriage is very convoluted. Shoto believes that his father bought his mother like livestock. However, when we hear Rei's perspective, Enji dated her, he was nice to her, he got to know her, he bought her flowers, he did everything you're supposed to do as a boyfriend. And yeah, that could have all been a manipulative act from Endeavour, but for all intents and purposes, Rei seemed to want to marry Enji. I mean, maybe the real issue was that Enji used a matchmaker to track down a girl with the perfect quirk, but there's no hint that I've seen so far that Rei is either owned or she was forced to marry him. And even as far as getting divorced, a woman can be the one to initiate divorce in Japan, so it's not like she's locked in to being married to Endeavour until he decides to dump her. So I wonder if the issue may have been that Rei and her family were very much poor people, or they were very buried in debt, and Endeavour sort of used his money and his influence to make their lives better to make Rei want to marry him. I mean, that I could see as a possibility, so that maybe her family was really needling her to marry Enji, but again, there's really no sign so far that this was forced in any way. And as far as we can still tell, Rei wants to be married even though she can't be around her husband, which is again another peculiar thing, but there's nothing to stop the divorce either, so it's all very curious and something where I don't think we have all the pieces of the puzzle yet. At any rate, Rei and Enji get married, and after four attempts, they finally have the perfect quirk child who has both fire and ice powers. So that means when Shoto gets way too overheated from using his flame power, he can cool himself off with his ice powers and vice versa. So being able to regulate his body temperature pretty much gives Shoto an unstoppable quirk. So huzzah! Ding 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 ding! We have a winner kid here! But even so, Endeavour seemed to be abusive with his perfect mini-hero. Although again, I do need to pause and say that I'm not sure that Endeavour ever saw it that way. And I want to preface this by saying that my husband, my kids, and myself have all been involved in martial arts, so I know firsthand that it's kind of inevitable that somebody's gonna not throw the punch at the right time, or someone else is not gonna get out of the way you think they are, and then oops, you just drew blood by mistake. It just goes with the territory of doing anything physical. Sometimes people are gonna get hurt. So I wonder, could that brief scene where Endeavour's making a fist and Shoto's on the floor be some training mishap where Dad's telling him to toughen up and walk it off? I mean, I don't know if that's what happened, but I could see where that's a possibility. If you look at the old school martial artists, they held nothing back when they were in class, so they will have missing teeth and broken bone scars and just be really gnarly. So just depending on your style of training, you might be doing things that other people think are crazy or physically violent or just horrific when it's not when you're on the inside of it. However, I don't think there's anybody who would argue that whether Endeavour saw it that way or not, he was way too rough and damaging to his family. And when Rei would try to step in and get Endeavour to stop, that just set him off. He's like, wait, I know what I'm doing. I know how to train. You don't even do any kind of fighting, so how dare you question me? And he just snapped and hit her. Which, let's also be honest, that was probably not the first or last time that that happened. Enji bullied his wife until she broke, and that's just a flat out period. Whatever excuse he has in his head, that is what he did. And honestly, that is not the behavior that we expect to see out of a hero. It's not at all how they're trained to act. And as the heroes in this world have to be licensed by the government, that means that darker side of Endeavour's personality had to be really well hidden. But it also makes me wonder why that kind of violence would be Endeavour's default action to his own family. Whether you get in an argument and walk away, scream, punch the wall, punch your wife, many times people do that because it's behavior that was modeled for them as children. So when you're an adult and you're in a position of stress and you don't know what to do, you have this little Rolodex in your head that goes, oh wait, this is what my dad did, or this is what my mom did. And you end up subconsciously adopting those kind of behaviors because that's the only way you know how to cope with things. Which means, I would bet you that Enji's father was a very abusive man himself, and likely one who didn't have a quirk. Not having a quirk would make somebody more likely for one-on-one violence because they wouldn't have powers to throw your way. And if somebody felt inferior because they didn't have a quirk and maybe they drank a lot because of it, then fist-fighting just about anybody to prove that they're the boss, they're in charge, they're worth it, whatever, is likely something that they would adapt. And the drinking element would be particularly interesting because that gives somebody something to apologize for without ever really changing. They just start sobering up and going, oh, I'm so sorry, that wasn't me that hit you, it was the alcohol, oh, I can't believe that happened. And they really sell that lie to their wife and children so that they keep together as a family unit. The problem, though, is that the drunkard did not have any consequences for his actions, really, because he was forgiven without having to do anything. So in his head, he goes, hey, I smoothed that over pretty easily, so I can drink again and abuse again and do this over and over and over again. And Enji is just seeing these behaviors modeled nonstop during his childhood. And so Enji grows up, and to him, being in power, being the man, being the head of the household is dominating people. So that's the way that Enji handles his wife and children, because that's what he was modeled. And because Enji grew up never being good enough for his father, he tried to overcompensate for that by being good enough for the world. To be clear, though, that does not excuse any of Endeavour's actions. That just gives us a trail to follow to understand his psychological state. Enji grew up and took on his father's insecurities, and he tried to rise above them by being a hero, but dang it, All Might, for standing in the way of that number one hero spot. So, where I theorize that Endeavour's own father had an inferiority complex over being quirkless, Endeavour himself was faced with the same kind of inferiority because he could never get to the number one spot that he wanted so desperately. And that made him lash out in the same kind of ways that his own dad did. It was not easy to make a hybrid quirk child, and Shoto was Endeavour's one chance to allow a part of himself to rise above All Might, to be the best, catch all the Pokemon, and all that jazz. And Endeavour was so afraid that not training hard every minute of the day would leave too much room for another new hero to swoop in and take Shoto's shot at number one. Which, as we all know, that desire to force his son to the top blinded Enji so badly that he ruined his relationship with most of his family. Now, go to the end of season 4, and we suddenly see a very different Endeavour. All Might's officially out of the way, so now Endeavour finally gets his chance as the number one hero. Huzzah! And then it takes all of a day before Endeavour almost dies on the job. Boozah! But getting to the top, Endeavour finally has what he wants. However, that also extinguishes his drive to keep climbing, to keep fighting for the number one spot. And I think in that moment, Enji finally realizes the cost of that goal. He's standing victorious, sure, he's got what he always wanted, but he's also all alone. Maybe for the first time ever, that fog is cleared and Endeavour is really able to see what he's done to his family. At least in my opinion, Endeavour really starts to show some signs of remorse. For instance, Endeavour wants Shoto to be proud of him. It's not something that he needs to be successful. There's no political or economical gain from Shoto being proud of his father, and Endeavour is already number one now, so that pressure is off both him and Shoto. So I see a little glimmer in there that Endeavour really wants to atone for what he's done. It finally sunk in that he's the one making animosity in his household, and he wants to fix it. it. I think Enji wants to repair what he can at this point, maybe even regain Rei's trust so that she's not afraid of him, and eventually bring his family back together. Now, that doesn't mean that Endeavour gets to act nice for a few days and then sweep away years of miserable behavior, but I do see the potential in him to do better and change himself now that he finally caught that carrot on a stick. I might be overthinking it, but that's literally my job. And even though the doctors won't allow the two to meet, However, Toya was never quite strong enough to fully master his powers, which Endeavour blamed on Rei's weak personality. And that failure to pass muster caused Endeavour to ignore Toya. However, if he chooses a mate wisely, he could combine. Now that doesn't mean that Endeavour gets to act nice for a few days and then sweep away years of miserable. And yeah, that could have all been a manipulative. Words and such. And I'll preface this by saying that my husband, my kids, and myself have all been informed. And Endeavour was terrified that not training hard every minute of the day, And Endeavour was so afraid that not overly training every single minute of the day would. Okay, yeah, battery exhausted. So is my head. I'm doing my best. Today is not a good day. Well, family members, we're almost done, but I want to invite you to hang out with me in some other places. I'm on Twitter and Instagram as my own personal self, and I have a Facebook page too, but I mostly just post photos over there. And sometimes people say, hey, McGann, I want to mail you something. How do I do that? Easy. Just click the About tab on my channel page, and my most current P.O. Box info will be right there. I also run another channel, The Family. It's really a hodgepodge channel where we might post anything. Oh yeah, and I also sell shirts and stickers and stuff with the Fanily and the Fangirl logos. If that is your cup of tea, I have a link in every description of every video. Finally, if you want to help out the Fangirl channel and make sure I'm putting out video essays for years to come, the best way you can help is by subscribing and watching more of my videos, whether they're new, old, whatever. Maybe even share one or two on social media, help spread the word. People who watch to the end of videos like you helps to tell the site, hey, this is a good video, we should recommend it to other people. So if you made it this far, leave me a comment of something like, hey, I made it to the end. Love ya. See ya next time, family members. Bye.